Chris Reid, some exciting times coming up for yourself. Tell us what you've got coming up.
Yes, Ed, I leave on Wednesday to go to Lithuania for the World Under 17 Men's Championship. So we've got to stop off first in a little island called Las Palmas, where there's a pre-tournament on for the guys. So I'm going over there to do that as well. And then on to Lithuania for the World Under 17s, which goes for about a week and a half. And then come back for about a week, and then I'm off to the States for an NBA summer camp as well. So very much looking forward to the next month, I suppose.
We'll talk about the Under 17 World Championships first. How did that come about? Was it something you had to apply for? Were you selected for it? How did you get a gig there?
Yeah. So with all the World Champs and things like that, basically that's a FIBA-nominated event, which they obviously go through Basketball Australia, and you're nominated to do that, or I suppose requested to come across and nominated through FIBA. So obviously get that nomination first, and then Basketball Australia have to approve that nomination and agree to send the referees over. So basically comes through the powers that be from the basketball world, and then you get lucky enough to get to go.
Yeah, I guess it is lucky to go, but you will see some familiar faces over there. Australia's being coached by Guy Malloy and Jamie O'Loughlin, both SEABL coaches.
Yeah, well, part of the FIBA world is you don't actually get to referee your own country. So, yeah, I'll see them over there, but I won't get to referee the Australians. But, yeah, definitely, I'll see Guy over there through and had past experience through NBL and obviously with his current role of coaching Ballarat, and Jamie, obviously, down at Geelong. So, they're guys who have been around in the league for quite some time, and I suppose from an Australian point of view, wish them luck, but I obviously won't get to referee those guys. I'll be refereeing the other countries that are over there.
Sure. Talk about the NBA camps now. How did that opportunity spring up?
I was sort of lucky enough. Peter Carey, obviously the NBL referees manager, gave me a call and said that there's the opportunity to send someone across, and I was lucky enough to be nominated for that as well. So again, it was a nomination thing where there's one Australian. I think there's been a few go before, the likes of Scotty Butler. I think Billy may have gone across as well. So there hasn't been too many, but definitely looking forward to that experience as well when I get across there.
And is there any opportunity to get called up to call some senior NBA games, or is that unlikely?
Probably unlikely, and the mates will give me a bit of ribbing about that question for sure, so thanks for that one. It's more of an experience thing. Yep. There's obviously the guys who are doing that league, they're fully professional, so it's slightly different from here. So really it's an experience thing going over there, and I suppose what I'm hoping to learn from that experience is how they prepare and how they plan for their games. Obviously there's different rules and things like that, so it's an experience thing, and hopefully I can bring some things back from that camp to help me with my own refereeing here, both at NBL level and SEABL level, and also through hopefully future FIBA events as well.
And coming back to Australia, Chris, an opportunity to pass on some of the experience to other SEABL referees, other NBL referees, that kind of thing?
Yeah, definitely. I hope the guys sort of ask a few questions. Yeah. Part of the NBA summer camp is when I come back, that Basketball Australia and obviously out the FIBA Oceania zone, basically want to ride up on that. Mm-hmm. So obviously provide that to those guys. But, also from my local association here at Knox, and other NBL and SEABL referees, definitely looking forward to not only developing my own career, but then passing some of the knowledge and, as I said before, around the preparation and the planning and seeing how those guys go about it and learning from them as well.
Well, mate, we're sure you'll pick up plenty along the way, exciting times, and looking forward to hearing about your trip when you come back. Good luck, and thanks for your time today.
No worries. Thank you very much, Ed.